Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Domenico and today we're going to be discussing 6 of the biggest stock market mistakes that beginners make and that you have to avoid if you're planning on getting wealthy from the stock market in the long term. But before we do get into the video, don't forget to leave a like down below. It really helps out the channel in a massive way and it just takes 2 seconds to do. So just click that like button right down there and let's get right into the video. So the first mistake that beginners make in the stock market is buying a stock blindly. So what does this mean? Well, buying a stock blindly basically means buying a stock without doing full research on the business, knowing how they make their money, how well of a financial position they're in, and how much money they're actually making, and if they're even profitable. Okay, a lot of people are buying stocks because they hear on TV that someone on CNBC bought the stock, or their friend bought the stock and made some money, or someone else bought the stock and recommended they buy the stock, and then they go in and buy the stock right away without even knowing what the company actually does, if they're even selling anything, if they even have any revenue, if they're even making any money. So this is really important to know what the business does, how they make their money, and you have to fully understand the company before you buy the stock. I mean, how important is it if you're buying an entire business to know what the business actually does? Would you go out and spend $500,000 on a business and not even know what they sell? No. But why would you do that with the stock? It's the exact same thing. You're taking a gambling mentality in the stock market when you should be thinking of it as an actual business. Whether you're putting $500 or $500,000, in the end, you're buying a piece of a business and you have to know what that business actually does. If you don't, then let's say the stock goes down 10%, what are you going to do? Are you going to sell? Are you going to buy more? I mean, if you don't know what the business does and it goes down 10%, maybe you'll say, okay, I'll cut my losses here. But if you do know what the actual business does and you know that it's a fundamentally sound business, they're actually making a ton of money, and that the short term of the stock market fluctuations is causing the stock market to bring that stock down, then you'll actually buy more when it goes down 10% instead of selling or just holding the line and saying, I hope it goes back and then I'll sell it when I break even, right? You always hear that whenever a stock goes down, people say, okay, whenever it gets back to my cost basis, I'll sell it and I'll at least break even. I won't lose any money. Well, that's not investing then. Then you're basically gambling. The point of investing is to put money to use so it grows for you over time, not to stay stagnant. Then definitely you're losing money over time because of inflation, right? So when you're investing, you always have to know what business you're actually buying, what the business actually does, what the business actually produces, and then purchase the company, right? So otherwise you're just gambling in the stock market and this is not investing. So that is tip number one. Tip number two is short-term thinking. When you're investing in the stock market and you hear about traders, day traders, and they're making a ton of money here and there, well, the truth is 99% of day traders lose money within their first year and then quit, right? There's a very small minority of traders, whether it's by luck or by actual techniques, that actually make money in the long term. And I believe that stock market investing over the long term has to do with the fundamentals of the business, not if they're going to beat earnings this quarter or beat earnings next quarter, or if the graph shows that the chart is going up, or if there's a shoulder pattern that trends downwards. I don't really care about the chart, to be honest. I don't even look at the chart when I'm investing in a stock, right? So you always want to think about the long term and the fundamentals of the business, what the business actually does, what they produce, what they're doing, what they're going to be doing in 5 years, instead of thinking what earnings are coming out next week and if they're going to be beating earnings or on EPS or the revenues, or if they're going to beat gross margins by 300 basis points. Instead of thinking that short term, you want to think longer term. What are they going to be doing in 5 years? Analysts have them doing $1 billion. Well, I think they're going to be doing $3 billion. Right, in 5 years. And that's where you make your real money in the stock market, by disagreeing with analysts, not in the short term, but in the long term. Because, for example, even if a company comes out with an earnings report and they beat on every single metric, the stock can still go down. And we saw this recently with a few of the stocks that came out with massive, massive beats on top line, bottom line, margins, expectations, guidance, everything. And the stock still went down. For example, all the big tech names, we have Apple, Facebook, Google, all those, Amazon. All those companies came out with massive earnings beats, guidance beats, revenues beats, and the stock still went down. We had Corsair Gaming. We had Tattooed Chef that came out with a massive acquisition. The stocks went down. So you can never look at these short-term things and think, oh, I think this is a bad company. No, because these things, these downtrends in stocks after phenomenal news could present fantastic buying opportunities for the long term. So you never want to think of it in a short-term manner, but rather take these short-term fluctuations and use them to your advantage for long-term investing. Tip number three is buying a stock at the top. Now, usually when you see people buying a stock, they can say a few things. They can say that the business is fundamentally sound, that they heard someone else buying it, or they can say, I'm buying the stock because it went up and I want to get on the bandwagon of making some money. My neighbor made some money, my friend made some money, my family member made some money. I want to make some money too because it's been going up so much over the short term that I really want to get in as well. This is a huge mistake. You never want to get in a stock that's been running for no fundamental reason. I mean, obviously, if a company made a huge acquisition and it goes up 10% and you look at the acquisition, you say, oh my God, this is going to be huge for the company in the long term. You run your numbers, you say, okay, I do believe that the stock is still undervalued. I'm going to buy it. Even though it went up, it doesn't matter. I'm still going to buy it. Perfectly fine. But if you're buying a stock just because it's gone up and nothing else has changed, if people are simply buying it and making money and you're buying it because you want to make money because they did and you think you're smarter than them and you want to make money because you're saying, wow, that guy made money, I'm going to make money too, this is a huge mistake because this basically means you're probably going to be buying at the top. I mean, think about GameStop and when it went to $450. Imagine that last guy that bought it at $450, right? He bought it because the stock was going up, and now he's down at least 50%, if not more, right? So you never want to buy a stock simply because it's been going up. Yes, you can buy it once it's been going up. Definitely. You can never catch the bottom either, right? So if a company is going up and you still believe in it, you can definitely buy in if you think it's still undervalued. However, you're not buying it because it's gone up, because a lot of people do. And then when it starts going down, they sell and they lose money. And then they never come back to the stock market and they say the stock market's a scam. And that's not the case. It's just because they bought simply because it was going up and no other fundamental reason. All right, so tip number four is selling a stock way too soon. So a lot of people, when they're looking at their portfolio and they see some stocks are up and some stocks are down, usually what they do if they're beginners in the stock market, they usually sell the winners and keep the losers, right? They say, okay, this stock ran up 10%, I'm gonna sell it, get that 10%, and this stock's down 10%, I'm gonna keep that and wait until it breaks even, then I'll sell it so I don't lose money. This is definitely not the way to look at stock market investing. If you're investing, you want to look at the fundamentals of the business and make decisions off of that. So if a stock is up 10%, but you believe that the fundamental valuation of the company is still undervalued and it still has 200% to go in the next 5 years, why would you sell it at a 10% gain when you can get a 210% gain in the future, right? So for example, when I bought Tesla at $238 pre-split, right? And the stock was going $300, $400, $450, $500 even, right? I could have sold, I could have doubled my money, right? But why didn't I sell? Well, my fundamental valuation of the business told me that the company was worth at least $3,000, if not more in the long term, right? So why would I sell it at $500 if I know fundamentally, based on the valuation that I created, based on my numbers that I ran, that it's gonna be worth $3,000? I'm leaving $2,500 of profit on the table, right? So yes, I could have doubled my money in a few months span, but why would I do so if I believe that it's gonna 5X in the future, right? So number one is always never sell businesses only because, or stocks, which I think of businesses, never sell them just because they went up, and never hold the losers just because they're losers and you want to break even on them. Don't be scared to take a loss on the stock. So this is a double-edged sword here. You never want to sell your winners too soon or sell your losers too late, right? So for example, I bought Carnival before the pandemic, right? And they went down significantly. But when I saw the amount of debt that they were taking on and the interest rates that they're paying on this debt, if the government would have never stepped in, it would have bankrupted the company for sure. But the thing is, the government did step in. However, the company will probably never fully recover for at least another decade from this debt that they took on, from the interest payments only that they have to make on that debt. Is going to be immense for a long time in the future. And this hurt my fundamental valuation of the business, and I saw it as hurting the valuation of the company. And when I ran my numbers again based on this new debt that they acquired because of the pandemic, again, it was a 100 year event, so no one could have predicted this. However, once I ran my new numbers, I saw that this was not a fundamentally sound business anymore that I can keep my money in. So even though I was down about 50% on the position, I still sold because I knew that fundamentally the business would not recover for at least another decade, and I can't wait that long just to recover my money, because there's a lot of other places where I could put my money. Remember, the stock market is an opportunity cost game. So you have two stocks, you have to pick between the one that has the lower risk but the higher return, right? You always have to take that risk return into consideration. So with Carnival, the risk was definitely there and the return just wasn't there really. In the long term, I mean, yes, it could double, go back to where it was, But I really found better opportunities in the market at that point, which I don't regret selling. So you never want to sell a company just because it's gone up a bit. You have to take into account your actual valuation of the business and where you think it's actually going to go in the long term. And then you never want to keep losers just because they're losers and you don't want to lose money on them. I mean, if you have to take a loss, you have to take a loss, and you will take a loss in the long term. If you're in the stock market long enough, you will take a loss. It's impossible to be right 100% of the time because there's always some risk factor that you didn't take into consideration. For example, a pandemic or something that just came out of nowhere, or something that management did, or something you overlooked, or something, a deal gone wrong, an acquisition gone wrong, something gone wrong. There's always something that's going to go wrong and you're always going to lose money on at least some of your stock picks, right? So you never want to keep a loser just because you fear losing money on that position. Take the loss and move on. Take the loss, learn lessons, and move on to your next stock. Tip number five is buying too many stocks. So this is a big one. So I'm a big student of Warren Buffett, okay? And Warren Buffett always preaches never to be over diversified. So let's say you have $1,000 in the market. Would it be wiser to be in 50 different stocks or 2 different stocks? Right? Well, if you're in 50 different stocks, you might have a home run, right? You might have put $50 in the stock and then it gone up 10 times, but you made $450. Imagine if that would have been one of your top 2 stocks or top 3 stocks. If you have only 3 stocks, if you have only $1,000, having 3 stocks is not being under diversified. You have a very small amount of money. So you want to concentrate that money in your highest conviction stock. So like Warren Buffett says, you'll never believe in stock number 47 as much as you believe in stock number 2 or stock number 1. Why wouldn't you want to buy more of stock number 2 than buying stock number 47, right? Because you're going to believe in stock number 2 more. So why wouldn't you want to put your money towards that higher conviction play? Why just buy more stocks just to be more diversified? In my opinion, having 5 to 10 stocks, even with a significantly larger portfolio in the hundreds of thousands of dollars, is okay because you're well diversified. Imagine if you had 5 or 10 whole businesses. Would you not think that that's a well-diversified business person? Of course you would. Having 5 to 10 businesses in different industries and different subsectors, that's phenomenal, right? That's more than well-diversified, really. A lot of wealthy people, a lot of billionaires, basically, make all their money from one successful business. So imagine you're an investor in that one successful business, right? But you always have to mitigate risk, of course. So that's why you have to invest in 5 to 10 businesses to be well-diversified. However, you have to be concentrated enough for your positions to actually matter, right? If a position worth $100 goes up 10x, great, it's now worth 1,000. But if you really believed in that company, why didn't you put 500, 1,000, 10,000? Why didn't you put more money in that position if you really believed in it? Why are you keeping that $100? Because you have to have 50 stocks? That makes no sense, because if you have 5 to 10 businesses, again, you're well diversified. Think of it in the same way for businesses. And the final mistake that stock market beginners make is never getting in. Okay, so a lot of people always say, okay, well, I'm gonna wait till the market crashes and then I'll get in, right? They've been saying this since 2009. I missed the bottom, but I'm gonna get in the next time it falls. Well, then what happened? The COVID-19 pandemic hit, and a lot of people saw the market dip and said, but wait, this is a 100-year event. I don't wanna get in right now. Let's just wait for some clarity. Before the clarity came, the stock market rallied and now we're at all-time highs. So what is the moral of the story here? Well, you're never going to catch the bottom. The point is always to get in. You never want to put all your money all in at once, because the stock market could continue falling and you'll have some better buying opportunities in the future. However, if you do think that a company is undervalued, why would you care what the market in general is doing? If I find a company that's 50% undervalued from where I think it should be, why wouldn't I buy it? Because I think the market's going to go down in the next month? I don't really care. If the business is a sound business and I believe it's undervalued, why wouldn't I at least buy 10%, 15%, 20% of my position that I want to build out? So let's say I want to put $10,000 in a position. Why wouldn't I buy $1,000 to start with? Even though I believe the stock market's going to go down, fine, but I want to get in. The thing is always getting in. You always want to get in. Get your foot in the door. I mean, you can do as much research as you want before getting in the market, but not actually being in the market will limit the amount of knowledge you'll have about investing, because investing is a learning game from experience. And you have to have experience in the market to really know how it is to invest, what you're doing wrong, and to learn new lessons. Of course, when you're starting off, you're not gonna start off by putting $100,000, $1 million, $2 million, $10 million in the market all at once, right? You're gonna start with small sums, And if you make a mistake, fine, it costed you $100, it costs you $500, right? They're very small mistakes. However, you never want to start off with a huge amount of money, because if you don't know what you're doing, it's going to turn out badly. You're always going to make a mistake at the beginning. And if you do, it's going to cost you $10,000, $100,000, a few hundred thousand dollars if you're starting off with big sums of money. So again, you always want to start off with a little sum of money, but you always want to start. The hard part is always starting. And people always delay it, saying, I'm going to wait till the next crash. I'm going to wait till the next crash. And they never get in, because the next crash always scares them. And the best time to get in is those crashes. However, a lot of people are scared. And that's the time that they don't want to invest, because they fear losing their job, or they fear what's going to happen with the economy. Or, for example, with the China tariffs, all the China companies got hit, all the Chinese companies, all the companies that did business with China. I remember I bought into Skyworks Solutions, a chip company, and a semiconductor company, and basically they did a lot of business with Huawei, and they lost a lot of business. I think they lost 30% of their revenues in that year because of the China tariffs that President Trump put in. However, I bought in because I knew that the fundamentals of the business were sound. And even though they lost that 30%, that they would recover in the long term. And they had a phenomenal balance sheet and they could withstand this hit. Again, with Facebook, when I got in Facebook was being hit by the controversy of the scandal where they lost all the users' data, right? And people were saying, I'm never going to use Facebook again, right? I'm never going to go on Facebook again. I'm never going to post on Facebook. I'm deleting the Facebook app. Everyone's still using Facebook. Everyone's still using Instagram, right? They're still having these discussions about privacy and data, and they always probably will, right? But the thing is, people are always worried when there is bad news, and this is the time to get in, but you have to get in. You can't wait because for this bad news to come and then stocks to fall, because you won't want to get in at that point. So you have to get in. That's the number one lesson out of all this video that you should take away, is that you have to get in. Just get started. Get started with a small amount of money, but get started and get invested. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video and learned some lessons to avoid these mistakes for yourself in the future. And it's probably going to save you a lot of money if you follow my tips. So I really hope you do. And if you did enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a like down below and subscribe, as well as clicking that notification bell so YouTube notifies you whenever I post a new video. And that really helps out the channel. So I really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in my next video. Have a great day.